Hello students, today we are going to start new lesson, circle. So in 9th standard we learned that definition of circle and properties of circle or parts of the circle, that is arc, segment, sector, secant, tangent of circle. Okay, so first, what is the definition of circle? So circle is a collection of all points in a plane from a fixed point or which is a fixed distance. Okay, so circle is collection of all points. These are points in a plane, okay, which is a at fixed distance from a fixed point. So this is fixed distance, okay. So these all points are situated at a fixed distance from a fixed point. So this fixed point we call it as a center of circle, and this fixed distance we call it as a radius of circle. Okay, so this definition we learn in class 9. Okay, then if this is radius, then radius generally we denoted it as small r. Okay, so circle we can represent as C in bracket O comma R. So circle having center is O and radius is R. So we denote circle like this way, C in bracket we can write O comma R. O is the center of circle, R is a radius of circle. Okay, so this is basic information. Okay, after that, if we consider circle and a line, okay, suppose this is a line L and this is a circle having center is O and radius is R. Okay, so there are three cases. This line either intersect circle in two distinct points, okay, means like this way, this is a circle and line L intersect circle in two distinct points. So A and B are two different points or distinct points, and this line L intersect circle in two distinct points, or it intersect circle at one point, or we can say that it touch circle at one point. So this is line L and it intersect circle at one point, point P. Okay, so there are three cases. So in this first case, line L does not intersect circle. In second case, line L intersect circle in two distinct points, and in third case, line L intersect circle at a point P, okay, or at one point. So here this line L we called it as a secant of circle. So this is called secant of circle. And if line L touch circle at a point or intersect a circle at a point, then we can say that this line L is called as a tangent. Okay, so here it is a secant, or if it is a line segment only, if we consider AB is a line segment, then we call it as a chord, and if line L is there, then we call it as a secant. Okay, so definition of secant, we can write it as, if line L intersect circle in two distinct points, then line is called as a secant. Okay, and another definition of, means next definition of tangent is, if line L intersect circle at a point, then this line L is called as a tangent of a circle. Okay, and this point P, this is common point for tangent also and for circle also. So this point P is called as a point of contact. Okay, so this 3 to 4 terms are there, which are basic terms, that is a secant, tangent and point of contact. Okay, so this is point of contact, means it is common common of line L and or tangent L and circle. Okay, so this is called point of contact, and this tangent word comes from tangere, that is a Latin word. So this is a Latin word. So this tangent word come from this Latin word. Okay, now we will see some properties of tangent. Okay, so these are basic terms related with the circle and which are needed for the next point. Okay, so now we will see properties of tangent of circle. Okay, so first property is that is a theorem. A tangent to a circle is perpendicular to radius through the point of contact. Okay, so first we draw diagram. So this is a circle having center is O and radius is R, and this is a tangent AB and point of contact is given P. Okay, so we have to show that this OP is perpendicular to AB. Okay, so for that we have to take a point Q on AB other than point P, and we have to show that this OP is a shortest distance among all these distances joining from point O to point AB. Okay, point on AB. Okay, so see here, if I am taking point O is here, okay, and this is a line AB, this is OP. Suppose if we have to show that OP is perpendicular to AB, then for that we have to show that this OP is the shortest distance from point O to a point P on AB. Okay, means we have to show that this OP is the shortest distance among all these points on AB. So if I am taking this OQ point here, so we have to show that OP is less than OQ. Okay, means if I am taking suppose this R also, so we have to show that this OP is shorter than OR or OQ. Okay, so here I am taking only one point, that is a point Q. We have to show that this OP is shortest distance than OQ. Okay, so if we show that this is the shortest distance, then it is a perpendicular distance, because we know that shortest distance is a perpendicular distance. So if OP is the shortest distance from point O, then this OP is a perpendicular to AB. So same concept we have to use here. We have to show that OP is a shortest distance. Okay, so first we have to write what is a given. So here given is a circle C having center is O, radius is R, and tangent AB. Okay, then what we have to prove? We have to prove that OP perpendicular to AB, and construction is take a point Q other than P and join OQ, which intersect circle at point R. Which intersect circle at R means this OQ intersect circle at point R. Okay, now we have to show that this OP perpendicular to AB means OP is the shortest distance among all these distances. Okay, so first we have to write, we have to show that OP perpendicular to AB means OP is the shortest distance among all distances from point O to a point, to any point on AB. Okay, so we have to show that this OP is the shortest distance among all these distances from point O to any point on AB, okay, except this P. Okay, now here OP is equal to OQ, sorry, OP is equal to OR, because OP and OR are radius of circle, so OP is equal to OR, that is a radii of circle. Okay, so OP is equal to OR. Now here OQ we can write OR plus RQ. OQ is equal to OR plus RQ. Okay, now OQ is equal to OR plus RQ. So if OQ is equal to OR plus RQ, then OQ greater than OR. Okay, this we can write it as, suppose if phi, we can write 3 plus 2, then phi is greater than 3 also, and phi is greater than 2 also. Okay, similarly OQ we can write OR plus RQ, so OQ greater than OR also, and OQ greater than RQ also. Here I am writing only OQ greater than OR. Okay, so OQ greater than OR, but OR and OP are equal, so instead of OR we can write OP. So OQ greater than OP, that is we can write OP less than OQ, means this statement we write only like this way, OP less than OQ. So if OP less than OQ, okay, so if we take another distance, suppose if I am taking here another point S, and if we join OS, then similarly we can prove that this OP is less than OS. Okay, means OP is the shortest distance among all these distances joining from point O to any other point on AB. Okay, so here we can write OP is the shortest distance. Okay, therefore, so if OP is shortest distance, we can write OP perpendicular to AB. Okay, so here we proved this OP means radius, so radius is perpendicular to tangent. Okay, so this is the first property or first theorem. Then after that we will prove converse of this theorem. Okay, now second theorem is, that is the converse of first theorem, a line drawn through the end point of radius. So here AB is a line drawn through the end point of radius, so P is the end point of radius OP, and perpendicular to it, so it, this AB line is perpendicular to OP, so here angle P is right angle, and we have to show that this line is a tangent to a circle. Okay, means we have to show that this line AB intersects circle at only one point. Okay, so first what is given here, radius OP of circle COR and line APB, okay, this we can write like this way also, line APB is perpendicular to OP. So this is given, perpendicular to OP. Okay, so OP is a radius and APB line means line AB is perpendicular to OP. We have to prove that AB is a tangent to the circle. Okay, so here we have to take a point Q on AB other than P. So in proof we write like this way, take a point Q on AB other than P, and what is given, that is OP perpendicular to AB. So Q point is on AB other than P and OP perpendicular to AB. So if OP is perpendicular to AB, means OP is the shortest distance, okay? So among all line segments, joining O to a point on AB, OP is the shortest. Okay, so this OP is the shortest distance among all the line segments joining from O to a point on AB. Means we can write this OP is less than OQ, or in another way we can write OQ greater than OP. Okay, means if this OQ distance is greater than OP, here OP is radius, and if OQ greater than OP, means Q point lies outside the circle. Okay, so here Q point lies outside the circle. Okay, so if I am taking any other point other than P on line AB, we can show that all the points lies outside the circle, means only one point is there, P, which is lies on the circle, and APB line intersect circle at a point. So if line AB intersect circle at a point, so we can say that this AB is a tangent to the circle at point P. Okay, so here we can write all point other than P lies outside the circle. Therefore, we can say that this AB line, so therefore line AB intersect circle at a point P. So if AB intersect a point P, so we can say that line AB, so thus line AB is a tangent to a circle at point P. Okay, so we have to prove this AB line is a tangent to the point P. Okay, so we have to start from this. Okay, so we have to show that first OP is less than OQ. So if OP is less than OQ, this Q point lies outside the circle. So if I am taking any point other than point P, all these points are outside the circle. So if all point other than P lies outside the circle, then line AB intersects circle at only one point P. Okay, and if line intersects circle at a point, then we can say that this line is a tangent to the circle at point P. Okay, now we will take example based on these two theorems. Okay, first example is a tangent PQ at a point P of a circle of radius 5 cm meets a line through the center O at a point Q, so that OQ is equal to 13 cm. Find the length of PQ. Okay, so first we draw diagram. A tangent PQ at a point P of a circle. So P point lies on a circle. A tangent PQ, okay, a tangent PQ at a point P of a circle of radius 5 cm. Okay, center is O given. Okay, meets a line through the center O. So this OP, that is a radius, and this is a 5 cm given. Okay, next statement, meets a line through the center O at a point Q, so that OQ is equal to 13 cm. Okay, means this PQ line meets the line through the center O at a point Q. So these two line meets at point Q and OQ is given 13 cm. We have to find length of PQ, means this is a length of tangent. Okay, so if this is a circle and this is a tangent, suppose, then we cannot consider this AB as a length of tangent. Length of tangent we calculate from point P, that is a point of contact, and either this point B or point A. Okay, so this is PB or PA, it's called as a length of tangent. Okay, now here this PQ is a length of tangent and we have to find length of PQ. Okay, now this is easy. From theorem 1 we can say that this tangent PQ is perpendicular to radius, or we can write angle between radius and tangent is right angle. Okay, and if we use Pythagoras theorem, in triangle OPQ we will get length of PQ. Okay, so we will start to write solution. Okay, so here first write in triangle OPQ, angle OPQ is equal to 90 degree, and reason is angle between radius and tangent. Okay, angle between radius and tangent. Then by Pythagoras theorem, we can write OQ square is equal to OP square plus PQ square. Okay, OQ square, that is a 13 square is equal to OP is 5 square plus PQ square. So 13 square 169, this is 25 PQ square. So PQ square is equal to 169 minus 25. So PQ square is equal to 144. So PQ is equal to 12. Okay, this is a centimeter. So PQ is equal to 12 centimeter, that is a length of tangent, it is a 12 centimeter. Okay, now we will take second example. Okay, second example is a line through the center O of a circle of radius 7 centimeter cuts the tangent at a point P on the circle at Q such that PQ 24 centimeter, find OQ. Okay, so first read this again. A line through the center O, so O is a center, line through the center O of a circle of radius 7, so this is radius, this is 7 centimeter, cuts the tangent at a point P. So this tangent at a point P, okay, this is a tangent at a point P, and line through the center O cuts the tangent at point P at Q. So this point is Q and this line cuts tangent at point Q such that PQ is equal to 24 centimeter. So this distance is given 24 centimeter and we have to find OQ. Okay, so again by using theorem 1, angle between the radius and tangent is right angle, and we can use here Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so first write in triangle OPQ, angle OPQ is equal to 90 degree, angle between radius and tangent then by Pythagoras theorem, then by Pythagoras theorem we can write OQ square is equal to OP square plus PQ square. Okay, so OP square, that is 7 square plus 24 square, 7 square is 49, 24 square is 576. So if we add this we will get 625. So OQ square is equal to 625, then OQ is equal to 25. Okay, it is a centimeter. So OQ is equal to 25 centimeter. Okay.